Venerable Uppekka, a bhikkhuni at Dhammasara Nuns Monastery. So we have come here today to express our gratitude to Ajahn Brahm. And we're doing that today by offering the gift of our practice. So you may remember the words of the Buddha himself when the comparison that he made, that greater than feeding the Tathagata himself and greater than feeding the whole Sangha is to have developed a mind of loving kindness, even for a moment, even the moment that it takes to pull a cow's udder. So today we are sitting here together to radiate metta to all beings, and in particular to Ajahn Brahm, on the occasion of his 70th birthday. We do this with great respect and gratitude because it is rare to come across someone who lives by the Dhamma, who embodies the Dhamma. Because we have wandered around sansara for so long, searching for the truth, searching for someone who can show us the truth. And we are so fortunate to have found it. And especially for myself as a female, I am grateful, so grateful for the opportunity to live the life of a renunciate, to live the life of a fully ordained nun. So, to begin this session, and I thought as an inspiration, I would chant the Buddha's words himself, the Buddha's words on the four divine abidings. I thought this would be an inspiration for this session on metta meditation. So I will begin the chant. I will chant in Pali and in English. Metta sahagatena cetasa ekam disam bharitva viharati tatha dutiyam tatha tatiyam tatha chatuttham iti uddhamado tiriyang sabbadi sabbattataya sabbavantang loka metta sahagatena cetasa vipulena mahagatena appamadena averena abhyapajjena paritnva viharati karuna sahagatena cetasa ekam dhissam bharitnva viharati tatha dutiyam tatha tatiyam tatha chatuttham Iti uddhama dothiriyam sabba disabbattataya sabba vantam loka karuna sahagatena cetasa vipulena mahagatena appamadena averena abhyapajena paritnva viharati mudita sahagatena cetasa ekam disang paritnva viharati tatha dutiyam tatha tatiyam tatha chatuttang iti uddhamado tiriyam sabdi sabbattataya sabbavantang lokang mudita sahagatena cetasa vipulena mahagatena appamadena averena abhyapajena paritnva viharati upekha sahagatena cetasa ekam disang bharitnva viharati tatha dutiyam tatha tatiyam chata chatuttham iti uddhamado tiriyam sabdi sabbattataya sabbavantam loka upekha sahagatena cetasa vipulena mahagatena appamadena averena paritnva viharati iti. I will abide, pervading one quarter, with a mind imbued with loving kindness. Likewise the second, likewise the third, likewise the fourth. Above and below, around and everywhere, to all as to myself. I will abide pervading the all-encompassing world with a mind imbued with loving kindness. Abundant, exalted, immeasurable, without hostility and without ill will. I will abide pervading the all-encompassing world with a mind imbued with compassion. Likewise the second, likewise the third, likewise the fourth. Above and below, around and everywhere, to all as to myself. I will abide by the all-encompassing world with a mind imbued with compassion, abundant, exalted, immeasurable, without hostility and without ill will. I will abide pervading the all-encompassing world with a mind imbued with gladness. Likewise the second, likewise the third, likewise the fourth. Above and below, around and everywhere, to all as to myself. I will abide pervading the all-encompassing world with a mind imbued with gladness, abundant, exalted, immeasurable, without hostility and without ill will. I will abide pervading the all-encompassing world with a mind imbued with equanimity. Likewise the second, likewise the third, likewise the fourth. Above and below, around and everywhere, to all as to myself. I will abide pervading the all-encompassing world with a mind imbued with equanimity, abundant, exalted, immeasurable, without hostility and without ill will. So we wish in this session, we wish Ajahn Brahm that his time in sansara is extremely short and that he continues to have a brilliant mind that inspires us. And may he continue to have the good health to be able to teach and spread the Dhamma for the welfare and benefit of all beings. Now we practice metta meditation in our own time for the next little while. As we come to the end of our session, we look at our minds and see how it has changed. Does it feel more open? More at ease, more expansive, less constricted, less of a sense of me? Now we share the goodness of our hearts, the goodness of our lives. We share this with all our teachers, with all our spiritual friends, our Kalyana Mittas, and particularly we express our gratitude to Ajahn Brahm. May this gift bring many beings great joy. Sadhu, sadhu, sadhu.